the great God of the universe, the creator of the heavens, the maker of the earth, comes to fulfill his own destined plan for man. Jesus gathers with his disciples just a few days after his triumphant entry, as his purpose continues to unfold.
He's a dreamer. He's just a dreamer. And I don't think I can take it one more day. I just can't stay. He promised us a kingdom, and he talked about a crown. But now I see I was better off before he brought me poverty. Now there's just a misery.
Judas, I love you, Judas. My heart is full of pain. I know what you must do. I feel that sad embrace. Judas, must it be Judas? His very dreams become the nightmare he must face.
Again, he's dreaming. This worthless feast must reach an end. Let's not return.
Judas, I love you, Judas. You'll never understand. My time is now at hand.
I've had enough. You're dreaming. Your plan is just a lie. I will not sit and watch my future die. It's all a lie.
Judas, I love you, Judas. Don't let my prayers and teachings be in vain. The lamb must be slain. I love you, Judas. Why can't you feel tomorrow's pain?
Thank you. And when they had sung a hymn, Jesus and several of his disciples went out to pray beneath the olive trees in the Garden of Gethsemane. Even with his closest friends, he is alone. His pain he is unable to share. His agony is beyond our imagination. And now, beneath the light of the desert sky, he feels his darkest night. The weight of the world is upon one man's shoulders.
Far away from the crowded streets, in the light of a million stars, all your friends are asleep, and you find you must keep watch alone.
Has come, the Son of Man is now betrayed into the hands of sinners.
As Jesus was speaking with his disciples, Judas, one of the 12, appeared. With him was an angry crowd armed with clubs and swords to arrest him.
Judas, I love you, Judas.
Then Judas went at once to Jesus, betraying him with a kiss. And they quickly seized Jesus and took him.
Forsaken, he's been betrayed by all. Suddenly comes the fateful call. What will you do with Jesus? Now Jesus stands alone on trial, ready to face the crowd, to walk his destined mile. In your heart, you're hearing all the while. What will you do with Jesus? What will you do? Someday your heart will be empty. just like Peter's done? Will you reject him? He is the living Son. What will you say when the question comes? What will you do with Jesus? What will you do?
Then Pilate appeared before the angry crowd.
I find no fault in him, this king of the Jews.
We have a king but Caesar. Crucify him.
What has he done? What has he done?
Crucify him.
What has he done? What has he done? As is your custom, I'll release to you one prisoner.
Barabbas.
But shall I crucify your king? But shall I crucify your king? But what has he done? But what has this man done?
When Pilate saw that an uproar was starting and that he was getting nowhere with the people, he took water and washed his hands in front of the crowd.
I am innocent of this man's blood. It is your responsibility.
Let his blood be on us and on our children. Let his blood be on us and on our children.
Away with him. Let him be crucified.
Scourged and beaten, a crown of thorns was forced upon his head, and a cross of splintered wood lay on his open wounds as he began his walk down the Via Dolorosa, the way of suffering.
Down the Via Dolorosa in Jerusalem that day, the soldiers tried to fill a narrow street,
but the crowd pressed in to see the man condemned to die on Calvary.
He was bleeding from a beating. There were stripes upon his back, and he wore a crown of thorns upon his head.
And he bore with every step the scorn of those who cried out.
Down the Via Dolorosa,
And when they reached Golgotha, they nailed his wounded body to the cross. As the angry mob cheered, his cross was raised between heaven and earth, and the Lamb of God was slain for the sins of the world.
Oh, Lord, my God.
I commend my spirit. It is finished.
And they took a sword and pierced the side of Jesus. Mary, his mother, stood and watched the death of her beloved son.
Oh,
when they pierced your side, did they think they could open your heart anymore? When they took away your life, what were they searching for? In you we saw
After his body had been taken down, he was wrapped in burial cloth. Then our Lord, who came to us as a child in a borrowed manger, was placed in a borrowed tomb. He was born with nothing and he died with nothing, yet he paid the price for the sins of the world. The tomb was sealed, and Roman soldiers stood guard to see that no one would disturb the body of Jesus. Early on Sunday morning, as the sun slowly rose above Jerusalem, warming the new day, Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of Jesus, made their way through the quiet street. The same street that cried, "Crucify him," just 3 days before. Now, they lay silent.
Mary, the Sabbath is over. I see the tomb, it's just ahead. Now with perfumes and with ointment, let us finish the burial of our dead. I've walked this way so many times before, yet this road seems longer today. My heart, it overtakes me. I've lost my son. The pain grows stronger with each step I take.
Find your dead, he is risen, Jesus is risen, as he said.
Thank the Lord, he is risen today, alleluia. But the men and angels say, alleluia. Praise the stars and shine. Sing it,
After his resurrection, Jesus appeared to his disciples and many others. He spoke to them of comfort and encouragement and a home he was going to prepare for them. You will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you, and you will be witnesses in Jerusalem and in all Judea and Samaria and to the ends of the earth. And when he had spoken these things, he was taken up. And while they looked towards heaven as he went up, behold, two men stood by them in white apparel, which also said, Ye men of Galilee, why stand ye gazing up into heaven? This same Jesus which is taken up from you into heaven shall so come in like manner as ye have seen him go into heaven.